One of the great advantages of being with FamilyTreeDNA.com is that you get to know your family genealogy through DNA. And my particular DNA is what is known as I1, which is Scandinavian in origin. Norway, Sweden, Finland, perhaps Denmark, but it is Viking in origin, which is interesting because I think we all have an interest in the Vikings for the stories about them. And one of the stories I particularly like is the story of the Battle of Hastings, and before the Battle of Hastings, the Battle of Stamford Bridge. And the Battle of Stamford Bridge took place only a couple of weeks before the Battle of Hastings. King Harold had his crown disputed by the Vikings in Norway, and also by William I of Normandy. As regards the Viking claim, Harold actually attacked a band of Vikings somewhere near, or possibly in, Stamford Bridge in Yorkshire. No one's quite sure exactly where the battle took place. But he attacked these Vikings, and they clearly weren't ready for the attack because a lot of them didn't have armour on. They were some way from their ships and were caught somewhat unawares. However, the key to the body, main body of the Vikings, was the bridge itself. And at that time, it is said, it was just wooden planking, and of course formed a pinch point between the English army and the Vikings. And that part of the bridge, the beginning part of the bridge, was guarded by a huge Norwegian, said to be 6 foot 9, 6 foot 10 in height, who had a very fearsome weapon, a Danish axe, it is said. And he guarded the bridge, and it is said that up to 40 English soldiers were killed by this Viking until King Harold decided on a more subtle ploy to remove him from that pinch point. And a man was sent in a half barrel along the water under the bridge, and the English soldier had a spear and caught the Viking completely unawares from underneath himself, as it were, and the spear was thrust up into him, and that was the end of that Viking. The English army then were able to get on to the land and attack the rest of the Vikings. As I say, were in a state of unawareness that they were being attacked and had not got their armour. But anyway, they were routed, severely routed, and it is said that out of 300 ships that they had with them, only 24 ships made it back to Norway, which shows the extent of the slaughter, really, of the Vikings by the English army. And of course, Harold's problems weren't ended there. He knew that William I, Duke of Normandy, was about to attack, and was in fact, news had got through to Harold that he was in Pevensey, in fact took quarters at Pevensey Castle, awaiting the arrival of the English army. It took Harold some days to get there, but when he got there, it was very interesting, having visited the actual battlefield, to find out that it was actually King Harold who had the higher ground, despite only getting to the battleground, as it were, today it's said to be battle, but no one is quite sure where the battle took place. But if it is battle, the high ground was had by Harold, and the Norman army took the lower ground, so they had to attack uphill. The English army did what they always, their main battle ploy was to have a shield wall. And they had a very firm shield wall, and the Normans found it very difficult to penetrate it. That particular conflict had opened with a gambit, in fact an insult really, by William, who sent his jester to talk to King Harold. Whatever was said in the brief conversation with King Harold and his entourage, one of the entourage killed the jester and the battle commenced. The Normans found it very hard to break through the English army because of these shields, but they had Normans on one flank, Bretons from Brittany on the other flank, and an assortment of Frenchmen, mercenaries elsewhere. The battle was won for William when the Bretons feigned to be defeated and were on the run, and they ran down the hill having tried to assault the shields and looked as if they were departing for the field. The English army, believing that was the case, broke their shield wall and ran down after them, leaving a hole for the rest of the Norman army to get behind the English lines, and that really was the end of the battle. And of course we know what happened to King Harold. He was killed. And of course this is shown on the Bayeux tapestry. He was killed with an arrow in his eye.